Matar Paneer is on the roll today. Let's begin. Alright, so we have made a lot of restaurant style recipes and dhaba style recipes. Today I'm to make a home style recipe, and if you like the recipe, let me know. I'll make more of home style recipes in the coming days. For now, let's begin making the matar paneer. So here I have a pan which I'm going to heat up. This is a very easy recipe to make. We're going to begin by cooking the masala for the recipe. The masala basically is the gravy for the recipe. We're going to cook the onions and tomatoes at first. For that, I'm going to add in oil, about 2 tablespoons of it. That shall suffice. To the hot oil, I'm going to add in a few cashew nuts and I'm going to roast them. These will help with the nuttiness and a little bit of thickness in the gravy. You can also go in with a little bit of melon seeds if you want to. We just want to make them sizzle a little bit. After that, I'm going to add in onions to it. Going to season this well with salt. So now we're going to cook the onions until they start to golden. The onions are now starting to get golden. I'm going to add in about a tablespoon of ginger garlic paste to it. Make sure to cook the ginger garlic paste well into the recipe. After the paste is cooked well, we're going to add in the tomatoes to it. Now all we have to do next is wait for it to cook down quite a bit or until it starts leaving the sides of the pan. So our masala or the concoction looks really well cooked. Now we are going to just turn off the flame and wait for it to cool down. After that, I am going to blend it to a smooth paste. So I have made a paste of the onions and tomatoes that we cooked earlier. Now we are going to finalize the matar paneer recipe, and I am going to add in some chopped onions right now as well. That will help bring out a new dimension to the recipe, and I absolutely love it. If you want to add in, you can add in, otherwise you can totally skip it if you want to. Now let me show you how I like to finish the recipe. So here I have a hot pan to which I am going to add in some more oil. I've taken about 2 tablespoons of oil. Again, you can go in with less if you want to. As the oil is hot, I'm going to add in some cumin seeds. To the spluttering cumin seeds, now we're going to add in chopped onions. Here I have one chopped onion. Going to add it in. We just want to cook it for like a minute or so, not any longer. I'm going to add in the spices to it now, which includes red chili powder. Next up is coriander powder, a little bit of kasuri methi as well, cumin powder. I like to add in a little bit of fennel powder, so about half a teaspoon of it goes in. Finally, to season it well, I'm going to add in half a more teaspoon of salt, a little bit of turmeric powder as well. Now we're going to roast the spices for about 2 minutes. Here I've got some finely chopped coriander. This goes really well with matar paneer. A lot of it goes in. Smells absolutely amazing. As this is cooking off right now, you can add in a little bit of tomato puree if you want to, or a little bit of ketchup if you want to. I'm going to go in with a tablespoon of tomato ketchup. Next up on the list is about 2 tablespoons of cream. Final ingredients include a little bit of ginger julienne and some chili slits. I'm going to add in the peas as well. Here I have about half a cup of boiled peas. Going to add in a little bit of water to this. This has been bubbling away for like 2-3 minutes. Now I'm going to add in the chopped paneer. So our matar paneer is ready. The final ingredient would be garam masala or a spice blend like this. What I've done is taken two black cardamoms, 4 to 5 cloves and a little piece of cinnamon and just roasted it and ground it to a coarse powder. This is what I prefer in my matar paneer. I'm to just sprinkle in a little bit of it. You can also use garam masala if you like it. That would be it. I'm to just mix it really well. Just like that, our matar paneer is all ready. Let me dig in. In it goes. It's true, nothing can compare home style cooking. Absolutely love this matar paneer recipe. Though this is just one style that we make matar paneer in my house. If you want me to show more home style recipes, then give this video a huge thumbs up. That will let me know that you guys like home style recipes. Thank you so much for watching. You can find the detailed text recipe in the description box down below. And by the way, you can also fry the paneer if you like it fried into the recipe. I just prefer it this way. I'm using malai paneer, so it's really soft and succulent. That's the way I like my matar paneer to be. So that's all for today. Thank you so much for watching. Watch more and subscribe. Bye. Take care.